Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about Git and GitHub. So this video is for beginners who want to learn about Git commands and how GitHub repository is being maintained. Plus, what is the advantage of Git and what is a version control system. So all these points we are going to discuss in this video. Main thing will be the difference between version control systems and how Git is better than other version control system. So friends, let us start the discussion. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please click on subscribe button so that you can get important updates whenever there is a new video on the channel. So first thing is Git definition. So Git is a distributed revision control and source management system. So first thing is distributed revision control. So distributed means it is not dependent upon any server. It is distributed means every client that is taking part in the project, it has a full replica of the project. So it is not a centralized revision control system. It is a distributed revision control system. That is why less overhead on the server. Then the second thing is it's a source management system. So your source code is managed. You have different version of the source code in the Git, and its main focus is on speed. And the other main thing is it is a free software. Now we will discuss what is a version control system. So version control system is a software. Through this software, software developers can work together. The main concept of version control system is more than two people or more than a group of people, they can work together simultaneously and they will not override the work of each other. And they maintain the history of every version. So if there is any problem, we can have always take the prior version. If this version is creating any issue, we will have another version, prior version, and we can take the backup. So version control system is a must requirement for a project in which there are a number of people involved. So it is very important that all the people are working simultaneously and they are not overwriting each other's work. Now, version control systems are of two types: centralized version control system and decentralized version control system. The concept that we are talking about, Git is a decentralized version control system. Now, what is a centralized version control system? Basically, centralized version control system, it stores all the files at one location, that is the central server. Then the major drawback is if the central server collapse or if there is any issue in the central server, then everything will collapse because you will not be able to access the server and you will not be able to get any files from the server. So the main concept, the main core is the central server. And it should be very, very much high capacity because everything will be stored on the central server. So it will involve a lot of cost, money, lot of resources to manage the central server. So these are all the drawbacks of central server. And keeping in mind the drawbacks of central server, Git has been created on the concept of decentralized version control system. So what is decentralized version control system? Basically, in decentralized version control system, the client, or you can say the machine, or you can say the person who is working on it, it check out the latest snapshot. Before working, it takes the latest snapshot. So if there are 50 people working, so they will take the latest snapshot. So the real backup will be on every machine. Latest backup will be on every machine before working on the project. So in this case, if the server goes down, there will be no issue because every client, every machine, every person who is working on the project, he has the exact replica of what was there on the server. This means that we don't need high server, high capacity server, more resources to manage the server because here the clients are doing all the things. Every copy, all the copy of the code plus images, everything that is involved in the project, that is there in the each client. So Git does not rely on central server, and that is why you can perform many operations when you are offline. You can see, you can create branches, view logs, perform other operations. So this is the main thing, and this is why, that is why it is, its speed is very, very high, because it is not centralized. It is decentralized version control system. Now, advantage of Git, it is free and open source. Git is released under GPL's open source license, and it is available freely. It is fast and small. Though Git mirrors entire repository, the size of the data on the client side is small. We have different Git commands through which it is done very easily. If the size of the project is very large, still using the Git software, you can do it very fast. The chances of losing data are very rare when there are multiple copies of it. If we talked about security, SHA-1 secure hash function is used for cryptography or security. As I have told you, there is no need of powerful hardware because it is decentralized. So every machine has exact copy of what is there on the server. And in case of distributed version control system, developers don't interact with server unless they need to push or pull. Otherwise, they are all doing on their machine, so less burden on the server. Once they want to push everything on the server, then only they interact. So there is no high traffic on the server. Now, if I talk about the Git steps, the first step in Git, if you are on the website of Git, the first thing you need to do is to create a repository. Then what is a repository? A repository basically it contains folders, files, images, videos, data sets, anything that is related to the project. So before doing anything, a repository needs to be created. Plus, on the root of the repository, there should be a README file that will tell the information about the project. Then a term that is related with Git is branch. Branching is the way to work on different versions. Suppose you have one version and you want to do some experiment. So what you do, instead of making changes in the main version, you create a branch, you do your experiment, you do your changes. If all the changes are done, then what you do, you merge that branch in the master branch, and that branch is available to all the developers. Then once you are doing all the steps, then final thing is you commit the changes. On GitHub, all the saved changes are called commits, and whenever you commit, you put a message so that a developer can recognize that, okay, this was the last commit and why this commit was done using that message. Then we have push and pull request. Before doing anything on the GitHub, you need to pull all the latest versions so that you have the latest version that was on the server. And push, once everything is done, you need to push it on the main branch so that the latest version is on the server, and once a new developer starts working, he get the fresh copy, latest copy from the server. So friends, this was everything about Git or GitHub. GitHub is on when you go on the web server. Git is a software you can install on your machine, and then you can do all this push, pull, create repository, and then you can do commit. So friends, if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. In the next video, we will be talking about the exact command of Git. Thank you for watching this video.